Hello friends, this is Gangadhar from Dimensions Guntur to discuss explanation for the quantitative questions from CGL 10th paper. Okay, right. So the first question is 51st one. It is given that a cistern has a leak which would empty it in 8 hours. A tap is turned on which admits 6 liters a minute into the cistern and it is now emptied in 12 hours. The cistern can hold. Another question. Okay, a cistern has a leak. Due to the leak, the cistern will be emptied in 8 hours. That means the capacity of the leak is, it empties in 8 hours. So in 1 hour, it empties 1/8 part of the tank. Okay, that means it takes 8 hours to completely empty the tank. Right, so a tap is turned, which admits 6 liters a minute into the cistern. In 1 minute, the tap will allow 6 liters of water into the cistern. Due to that, the leak would take 4 hours more. That means it is taking 12 hours to empty the tank. That means with the involvement of the tank, tap. With the involvement of the tap, the cistern is taking 4 more hours to empty the cistern. Okay. So with the involvement of the tap, enta amount of water aithe cistern loki enter avutundo, anta amount of water ni empty cheyalante, the leak is taking 4 hours more. Okay. So the tap is working 12 hours of time. Okay, tap in 12 hours. Since the tap is working 12 hours of time, in 12 hours, tap will allow 12 into 60 minutes, in 1 minute 6 liters, tap will allow 12 into 6 into 6 liters of water into the cistern. Okay, 6 is 36, into 12 we need to calculate. Okay, 12 6 is 72, okay, 12 3 is 36 and 7, 43, 4320 liters of the water will allow into the cistern by this tap. Okay, deeni valla the leak is taking 4 hours more. That means leak in 4 hours. In 4 hours, leak will empty 4320 liters. Okay, in 8 hours, the leak will empty double of this one. That means 8640 liters of water. Since the leak has a capacity to empty the tank in 8 hours, and by this it is emptying 8640 liters in 8 hours, ultimately the capacity of the tank will be 8640 liters. That was your answer. That was the first question. Okay. Now, second problem. The 52nd problem is the algebraic problem. It is given that A plus B plus C is equals to 0. Okay. And they ask us to calculate the value of the given expression. There are two different ways to solve this problem. One of the ways is completely using the algebraic properties. And the other way is we need to take certain values in the place of A, B and C, such that A plus B plus C is equals to 0. For suppose, take A is equals to 0, B as 1 and C as minus 1. So that the sum of these three values is 0. Now, they ask us to calculate the value of the expression A square by A square minus BC plus B square by B square minus CA plus C square by C square minus AB. Since we have the values of A, B and C, if you replace A, B, C with these values, since A is 0, this is 0. Since B is 1, this is 1 minus 1 minus 0. Since C is minus 1, C square is 1, 1 by 1 minus 0. This is 0, this is 1, this is 1, and your answer is 2. So, your answer is 2. For these type of problems, okay, for such type of problems, to find the value of the expression, we need to consider certain values in the place of A, B, and C. Okay, have you got a problem easy? I am taking like 0, 1, and minus 1. Alaga akkada meeru 2 minus 2 ila iskunte kodiga calculations ibbandikaranga unde avakasam untundi. And the next one is 53rd problem. Okay, for in this 53rd problem, they mentioned that in a certain party there was a bowl of rice for every 2 guests, a bowl of broth for every 3 of them, and a bowl of meat for every 4 of them. If all there were 65 bowls of food, then how many guests were there in the party is the question. Okay, so for example, there is a bowl of rice for every 2 guests. Okay, let the number of bowls of rice is x. Since x is the number of bowls of rice, for every 2 guests we have 1 bowl, so the total number of guests in the party are 2x. Okay, and next case, a bowl of broth for every 3 of them. Broth in the sense just like soup or just like what we call curry type anamata. Okay, just like soup anukunte, for every 3 of them there is a bowl of broth. For example, there are y number of bowls of broth. For every 3 we have 1 bowl. So total number of guests from these broth bowls is given as 3y. And they mentioned that there was a bowl of meat for every four of them. Suppose there are Z bowls of meat. Since for every four we have one bowl of meat, so total number of guests in the party, let it as 4Z. So total number of guests represented in point of view of the rice bowls, broth bowls, and then meat bowls. Okay, this is equals to some K. Treat it as K. Okay, and they mentioned that the total number of bowls as 65. So X plus Y plus Z is equals to 65. So what is X actually from there? The X value is K by 2, and the value of Y is K by 3, and the value of Z is K by 4, which is equals to 65. And we have to simplify. So what will be the LCM of 2, 3 and 4? LCM of 2, 3 and 4 is 12. So we need to multiply everything with 12. So to multiply everything with 12, okay? So this everything we need to multiply, this is K by 2. Into 12 in the sense, we will get 6. Into 12 in the sense, we will get 4. Into 12 means we will get 3. And here we will get 12. So the denominators will vanish. Now 6K, 4K, 3K is 13K. Okay, 13K is 65 into 12, and if you divide with 13, your answer will be 60. So totally, there are 60 guests in the party. Okay, this is 53rd problem. Then coming to 54th one, okay. In measuring the sides of a rectangular plot, one side is taken as 5% in excess and the other 6% in deficit. The error percent in area calculated of the plot is not here. Okay, we need to calculate the error percent in the area. That means change in area. Usually, we have a normal logic that in a product A and B, in the product of A and B, if A changes by X percent and B changes by Y percent, then the net change in the product AB is calculated by using the logic that X plus Y plus XY by 100. Here, area of the rectangle is L into B, length is changed by 5% in excess to take it as plus 5, and breadth is of 6% deficit to take it as minus 6. The product is given as minus 30 by 100. If you simplify, this is minus 1 and this is 0.3, and there is a change of 1.3%. This was 54th problem. And the next 55th problem. Okay, 55th problem. A triangle and a parallelogram are constructed on the same base such that their areas are equal. If the altitude of the parallelogram is 100 meters, then the altitude of the triangle is, okay? A triangle and a parallelogram are constructed. Okay, what? The area of the parallelogram is given by the rule that of base into height. Whereas the area of the parallelogram is given as base into height. They mentioned that base is same in both the cases, so take it as B. So B and B will get cancelled. And also they gave that altitude of the parallelogram is 100. So take it as 100. Then finally the height of the triangle will be 200. That was your answer. Okay, and the next one, which one of the 56th one, which one of the following is a factor for x cube minus 20x plus 32 is they are asking. First option is x plus 2. To check whether x plus 2 is a factor of the given polynomial or not, we need to replace x with minus 2 in this expression. Okay, if by replacing x with minus 2, if the result is 0, then x plus 2 is a factor. If the result is not 0, then check the other option, which is x minus 2. That means we need to replace x with 2. Okay, if we replace x with 2, if the result is 0, then x minus 2 is a factor. Like that, we need to check each and every option, and your answer is x minus 2. Okay, and the next one, 57th one. The ratio of the volume of a cube to that of the sphere, which can fit inside the cube, is Nadutunadu. We need to find the ratio between the volume of cube to the volume of the sphere, which was 57th problem. Volume of cube to that of the volume of the sphere. So, if usually the volume of the cube is of a cube, and volume of sphere is of 4 by 3 pi in the sense 22 by 7 r cube. But what is the radius here? Since the sphere is fitted inside the cube, since the sphere is fitting inside the cube, the diameter of the sphere will act like the edge of the cube. That means the diameter is a, so radius is a by 2. Instead of r cube, we need to write a by 2 whole cube, which is nothing but a cube by 8. These two will get cancelled. 4 2s is 8, 2 11s, and on reversing, you will get it as 21 is to 11, that was your answer. Then coming to 53rd problem. Okay, given that the sides of the right angle triangle are a plus 1 and a minus 1, always the largest length is the hypotenuse. Among these, a plus 1 is the largest. Then by the Pythagorean result, a plus 1 whole square is equals to a square plus a minus 1 whole square. If you send a minus 1 whole square this side, you will get that a square is equals to 4a. Finally, we have a is equals to 4. Since a is equals to 4, the sides will be 3, 4, 5. Among these, the largest possible length is 5. Which one is the hypotenuse? So your answer is 5. Then, 59th problem. For that 59th problem, root 600 is given and they ask us to calculate root 2 plus root 3 divided by root 3 minus root 2. Okay. Since they ask us to calculate this value, we need to multiply both numerator and the denominator with root 3 plus root 3. Since we are multiplying both with root 3 plus root 3, root 2, the denominator will become like 1, a minus b into a plus b. Whereas the numerator is a plus b whole square. So a plus b whole square, which is nothing but root 3 plus root 2 whole square. If you apply a plus b whole square here, a plus b plus 2 root a b is 2 root 6, which is nothing but 5 plus 2 root of root 600 is 24.49, whereas root 6 is 2.449. So we need to replace root 6 with 2.449. And on simplification, you will get the answer as 9.898. That was 59th problem. Okay. Then 60th problem. 60th problem is from averages. Okay. It is given that if the mean set of the observations of the 10 numbers is 10, the mean of 10 numbers is given as 20. Then they ask us to calculate the mean of all those 10 numbers raised by 4, 8, 12, like that. Okay. So the mean of x1, x2, x, and so on, xn is 20 plus the mean of 4, 8, and so on, 20, 40, we need to calculate. That means 4 plus 8 plus 12 plus and so on plus 40 divided by 10, we need to calculate. This is 20, whereas from this we need to pick out 4. The remaining values is 1 plus 2 plus and so on plus 10 divided by 10. This is 20 plus 4 into this value is 10 into 11 by 2 divided by 10. These two will get cancelled. 22 plus 20 is 42, and the average of the given numbers is 42. Okay, this was 60th problem, and the next one is 61st problem. Okay, in the 61st problem, they mentioned that there are 15 radical spokes in a wheel. There is a wheel, okay, radical spoke in the sense the radius lines. Okay, these type of lines, we have 15 radical spokes in the line, and all those lines are equally spaced with an angle. So since all those angles are equal, these 15 radical spokes will make 15 angles at the center. So since all those are equal, so 15 sine of that angle is equals to the total angle 360 degrees. So automatically each angle will be, okay, 360 by 15, that is nothing but 24 degrees. Since each angle is 24 degrees, then there are two spokes of which nadutunadu. Okay, we need to ever rendu spokes undali, vaati madhyana angle ela untundi. Okay, since each angle is 24 degrees, then angle between any two spokes is multiple of 24 surely. Okay, now, in the between two spokes, 24, between three, it will be 24 plus 24, and in co pair select just 24 multiply. So, angle 24 multiply from the first option lie along a diameter of the wheel. That means they mentioned that the angle between two spokes has 180 degrees. Since 180 is not a multiple of 24, that was not your option. Okay, second one is also not your option. Coming to the third one, they are inclined at an angle of 120 degrees is given. 120 degrees is a multiple of 24, so your answer is option C. Okay, and the next one is 62nd problem, is from trigonometry. It is given that sine x divided by sine of x by 8 is given. We need to simplify this one. For that, we need to use the rule of sine 2 theta. I think you are all aware that the value of sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. Okay, so we need to have a clear idea about all the trigonometric values and all the trigonometric formulae to solve the problems from trigonometry. Okay, the general rule is the sine 2 theta is 2 sine theta cos theta. Using that, we can express this sine x as 2 sine x by 2 cos x by 2. Okay, and again, we will apply the same rule for sine x by 2. Since we are applying the same rule for sine x by 2, this sine x by 2 can be replaced by 2 sine x by 4 cos x by 4. Again, we are going to apply the same rule for sine x by 4. Since we are applying the same rule for sine x by 4, this can be written as 2 sine x by 8 cos x by 8. And on simplification, sine x by 8 will get cancelled. You are left with the 2, 2, 2, 8, and then 8 cos x by 2, cos x by 4, and cos x by 8. Okay, that was 62nd problem. And the next one is 63rd problem. Given that profit is calculated on the selling price as 50% of selling price, then the actual profit percent we need to calculate. Since profit is 50% of selling price, okay, then what about the cost price? And what about the, what we call, cost price amount? Since profit is the half of the selling price, how can we calculate profit? Okay, So they mentioned that profit is equals to selling price by 2. Usually profit can be calculated by selling price minus cost price is equals to selling price by 2. From there, cost price is again selling price by 2. Cost price is selling price by 2, profit is also selling price by 2. So the profit, actual profit percentage is 100%. Okay. And the next one is 54th problem. Further, it is given that a train 100 meters long is running at the speed of 21 kilometers per hour. And another train of 150 meters long is running at the speed of 36 kilometers per hour. How long will the faster train take to pass the first train? Okay, since these two trains has to pass one another. Since these two has to pass one another, the total distance traveled covered by these two trains as the sum of the lengths of those two trains. Since the sum of the lengths of those two trains is 100 meters plus 150 meters, the distance is 250 meters. Okay, so we are going to calculate the time. So time can be calculated by the distance by speed. So distance is 250 kilometers, whereas coming speed in the sense, since the both the trains are moving, we need to observe the relative speed. Since both are moving in the same direction, the relative speed can be taken as the difference of the speeds of those two trains. That difference is 15 kilometers per hour, and we need to convert that 15 kilometers per hour into meters per second, since the distance is in terms of meters. So we need to multiply with 5 by 18. So 250 by 15 into 5 by 18. We need to simplify. So this is 3 5s and 3 6. 5 into 5 is 25, 25 tens. And on simplification, you get it as 60 seconds. And finally, your answer is 60 seconds. Okay? And the next one, 55th problem. So 55th problem, you need to mark it for review. Okay? So usually, in the papers of these online test papers, we are going to mark certain questions for the review, because those questions are different and those questions are somewhat logical, which are important for the coming examinations and coming competitions. Okay, I think this was somewhat logical and the important model, so you need to mark it for the review. Which one it is? 55th one. What is that one? It is given that we need to find out the remainder when divided by the number. Okay, this is the number. When this number is divided by 7, we need to find out the remainder. Okay, since we are going to concentrate on the remainder when this is divided by 7, so first of all, we need to calculate the remainder when these numbers are divided by 7. First of all, you need to divide 2 with 7 and find the remainder. Then divide this number with 7 and find the remainder. If you divide these 4 2s with 7, the remainder will be 3. So the remainder when divided by this number is equals to the remainder when divided by this number. Since when 7 is divided by this number, the remainder is 3, so both are equal anamata. Okay, when this 4 5 is divided by 7, the remainder is 4, so you need to concentrate on this number. This is enough. So actual idea is when this total number is divided by 7, you will get certain remainder. The same remainder you will get when this is divided by 7. Okay, same thing happens in this case also. So 3 power 5 5 5 plus 4 power 2 2 2. Okay, this is what we have. So we need to express it as 3 power 5 power 4 ones plus 4 power 2 power 4 ones. This is nothing but 3 power 5 is 243 power 4 ones plus 16 power 4 ones. This is in the form of x power n plus y power n, where n is odd. Okay, this is in the form. Okay, usually if n is odd, x power n plus y power n can be expressed as a multiple of x plus y. So this can be expressed as a multiple of x plus y. So what is x plus y here? 243 plus 16, 952. Okay, when it is divided by 7, the remainder is 0. So since it is a multiple of 7, this is a multiple of 7, this is a multiple of 7, so the given number is also multiple of 7. Finally, your remainder is 0. Okay, so sure, you have to mark it for the review. Okay, I mean review in the sense, these type of questions are somewhat rare and somewhat logical, which are very helpful in the competitions. Okay, that's what I am giving it as a markable. Okay, next one is 56th one. What is 56th one? A man takes a loan of 10,000 rupees. Okay, principal amount is 10,000 rupees and pays back 13,340 after 3 years. And what is the rate of compound interest? Okay, very traditional question. Okay, the amount is given as 13,310 and the principal is given as 10,000. The usual rule is 1 plus r by 100 power 3. So usually 1 0 will get cancelled. And we know that this is 11 cube, whereas this is 10 cube. Okay, always if you from every term, if you remove the cube, you will get it as 11 by 10 is equals to 1 plus r by 100. If you simplify directly, you will get the value of r as 10. So rate of interest is 10%. Okay, and the next question is 57th problem.
For that 57th problem, they asked us to find the number of ordered pairs of positive integers. Given that x plus 2y is equals to 100, we need to find out the number of positive integers. Okay, so x is a positive integer, y is a positive integer. In the sense, both x and y are the natural numbers. For example, if you take y is equals to 1, then 100 minus 2 is 98, x is 98. Y is equals to 2, x is 96. In the same manner, if you take y is equal to 49, you will get the value of x is equals to 2. When if you take y is equals to 50, x will become 0, but it is not possible. So from 50, there is no possibility for y. So the possible values for the y are 1 to 49. So the number of solutions are 49. Okay. And the next one is 68th problem. In a chess tournament, every person played one game with every other person in the group. The total number of games played that men played between themselves exceeded those played by men with women by 18. If there were 4 women in the tournament, totally how many games were played in the tournament? Okay, let the number of men involved in the tournament are n. Let the number of women involved in the tournament are 4. Then the number of games played by men among themselves, that means every man has to play with the other men. So okay, since every person has to mingle with the other person, the number of chances are n into n minus 1 by 2. Okay, and the number of games played by both men with women is given as 4n. But as per the problem, it is given that n into n minus 1 by 2 minus 4n as 18. Okay, from there we need to calculate the value of n. If you multiply everything with 2, this is n square minus n minus 8n is minus 9n minus 36 is equals to 0. 36 is 12 into 3 and 12 minus 3 is 9, and on solvation you will get it as n is equals to 12. So the number of men as 12. Okay, but actually what they are asking? They are asking to calculate the total number of games. Number of games played by the man is, since n is 12, 12 into 11 by 2, which is equals to 66. Whereas the number of games men and women together is given as 4 into 12, which is nothing but 48. Whereas the number of games played by woman itself is given as 4 into 3 by 2, nothing but what? Okay, 6. So we need to simplify. If you add all those things, you will get it as 120. So the total number of games as 120. Okay. Then 69th problem is a usual problem. They gave x is to y as 3 is to 2. And again, they asked to calculate a ratio. Since given a ratio and they asked to calculate a ratio, to directly take x is equals to 3 and y is equal to 2 to calculate that one. Okay. And then 70th problem is from the applications of trigonometry. That means we need to solve using trigonometry. From the ship masthead 150 meters height. Okay, from this ship mass, the angle of depression of the boat, okay, then there is a boat, the angle of depression means this angle, let it is theta, okay, since it is theta, this is also theta, this theta is given as what, cot inverse of 12 by 5, since theta is cot inverse of 12 by 5, we can write that cot theta is equals to 1 by 5, and they ask us to calculate the distance from the ship, they ask us to calculate this distance, okay, if you apply cot theta for this triangle, cot theta is adjacent side by opposite side, which is nothing but x by 150 is equals to 12 by 5. Okay, 5 30s, and then x is equals to 360. So this distance is 360 meters. Last 71 to 75, these are the questions based on the given line graph. Okay, so usually we call it as data interpretation type. The line graph contains number of shirts of X brand sold in shop A and shop B in 6 different months. In different months, October, November, December, January, February, and then March. The number of shirts sold by shop A and shop B of the shirts brand X and Richaru. Okay, 71st problem. It is given that the number of shirts sold in shop B is increased by what percent from November to December, they are asking. Okay, clearly from the graph, in November, the number of shirts sold by shop B is 200 and then in December, it is 320. The difference is 120. We need to calculate the increased percentage. So 120 divided by 200 into 100, we need to calculate. On simplification, you get it as 60%. Okay, and the next one is 72nd problem. So they ask us to calculate the difference between the total number of shirts sold in both the shops together. Okay, we need to calculate the values from both the graphs. October, February and March is one group. October, February, March is one group. And the other group, they mentioned that January, November and December. In October, both the shops together is mentioned as 150 plus 120 as 270. And in February, it is mentioned as 190 plus 100, which is nothing but 290. In March, it is given that 80 plus 50, 130. Whereas coming to January, it is given that 300 plus 270 as 570. In November, it is 460. In December, it is 670. we need to sum all these values. If you sum all these values, you get it as 690. If you sum all these values, you get it as 1700. They ask us the difference between these two, and your answer is option D, 1010. Then 73rd problem, in the same manner you need to calculate. You need to calculate the total value from October, November, December of shop A, and the same value from shop B, and again you need to calculate the increased percentage. Okay. Then 74th problem, what is the average number of shirts in shop A in October, November, December, February and March? Shop A and a line graph na observe chesthe, October, November, December, February, March. Okay, except January, the remaining all those values we need to add. If you add all those values, you will get it as 1030. Since they asked us to calculate the average, we need to divide with 5. Okay, 1030 by 5, and your answer is 206. Okay. Then coming to the last problem, which is 75th problem. For this 75th problem, what they are mentioning? The total number of shirts sold in shop B in September. Okay, the graph is indicating from October to March. But in this question, they are mentioning about September. In September, the sales is 20% less than the number of shirts in October. Since 20% less, we need to take it as 80% of the sales of October, which is 120. So 80% of 120 is 96. Okay. And after this September, again they mentioned about April. Okay, the graph is from up to March. In April, the sales is 20% more. That means 120% of the sales in March. In March, it is 50. So 120% of 50 is 60. So in September 96, in April the sales are 60. And the question they ask is the ratio between these two values. If you divide with 12, 12 8 is 96, 12 5 is 60, and your answer is 8 is to 5. So this is the explanation for CGL 10th paper. Okay, thank you. Before going to attempt each and every question, first of all you need to get a clear idea about the question. Understanding the question is very important in attempting. Okay, and ఈ ఆన్లైన్ ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ మీరు ఈజీగా ఫాలో అవ్వాలంటే ఫస్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఆల్ ఇట్ ఈస్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ టు అటెంప్ట్ ద ఎగ్జామినేషన్. ఓకే, ఆన్లైన్ టెస్ట్ రాసి ఈ ఎక్స్ప్లెనేషన్ ఫాలో అయితే సో సమ్ వాట్ యూ ఫీల్ కంఫర్టబుల్. రైట్, థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్.